2.6 families of functions. Families of functions are going to help you out with graphing because you're going to know what the thing looks like before you even start. If you look at number one, y equals x, you should just know when you see y equals x, when you just see an x to the first, it's going to be a line. So specifically, I'm going to draw a quick sketch of this. Y equals x looks something like this. Memorize that. Number two, when you see an x squared, now we might have other numbers involved like 2x squared or 3x squared minus 7, just something. It might, but it has an x squared in it. You should know that's going to be a parabola shape. So we can call it a U shape. Looks like that. Let me fix that. U shape. Square root of x. Square root. I describe it as an eyebrow. It's going to look like an eyebrow. All right. It's almost like half of a parabola or half of a U shape. And then number four, if you've got absolute value bars, that's a V shape. V shape. So memorize those four shapes. That will come in handy when you're about to graph. Now we're going to talk about transformations. The parent function is already graphed. Use transformations in the equation to sketch the child. All right, so parent functions, that's what these things are. This is just your basic, this is what it's going to look like. So we need to talk about transformations. First thing you see is that x squared. X squared tells you that it's going to be a parabola. But if you have a negative in front, it's going to flip it upside down. So that negative in front of x squared indicates a flip. And then this minus 2 after the x squared tells me that we're going to shift it down 2 units. So if we take this point right here and we shift it down 2 and flip this thing upside down, our parabola is going to look like that. Okay. Next one. When you've got some kind of subtraction or addition or whatever inside of the function, you see your absolute value bars, but the minus 2 is happening inside of the bars. That's going to be either left or right. And to me, what I think about is what number makes this equal 0 is 2, positive 2. So that tells me this is going to shift right by 2 units. All right. Some people remember it as it's the opposite of whatever you see, but I don't know if that's a very mathematical way to do it. But it's still going to be an absolute value shape. It's still going to be a V shape, but we're going to shift the thing right too. It's going to look like that. Next one, x plus 3. So here's your parent function. That's a line, but this means we're going to shift it up by 3 units. So 1, 2, 3, shift it up 3. It's going to look like that. Okay. The next one, you've got your square root. So that's your eyebrow shape. But inside the square root is either left or right. Okay. Now, again, inside, I think about what makes 0. What makes 0 would be negative 1. Negative 1 tells me to shift this thing left by 1 unit. And then the minus 2 over here is after the eyebrow function. That's going to be down 2. So we would take the graph and we would shift it left 1 and down 2. That's going to look like that. Okay. So those are transformations. Number 9, describe all transformations of the parent function. Well, first of all, see how there's an x squared? We know it's a parabola shape. That is an x squared parabola shape. Okay? But you've got two transformations. Inside of the function, that's going to be right one. And then over here, minus 3 is down 3. So if I was going to graph it, I would know it's a parabola shape, but I would take that parabola, that parent function, and go right 1 and down 3 and draw a new one. Number 10, you see how it's an absolute value, so that's a V shape. But this means left 3, and this part is up 1. Next one, think about what shape it is. Number 11, you've got an x squared in there. So x squared is a parabola shape. Inside the function, you think of it as opposite if you want to, but that's going to be right 4. And then after the function, that's going to be up 3. Those are your transformations. Problem 12. You've got absolute value. And so absolute value we know is a V-shape. But you see the negative in the front, that's a flip. So it's going to be an upside down V-shape. And after the function, plus 1 means up 1. Number 13, it's a square root function, so we know it's the eyebrow shape. But you've got this transformation inside the function, plus 4, that's going to be left 4. If it's inside the function, that's right or left. So number 14, you've got the same shape. You've still got that eyebrow shape, the square root shape. Inside the function, that's going to say right 3. And after that function, that's going to be up 4. Those are your transformations. Now 15, graph the image of the figure using the transformation given. So they're going to describe what to do. 15 says translation. Translation means slide. There's another transformation called a rotation, but this one's easier. Translation, you just slide it. So they want us to go 2 to the right and 6 down. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take each of these points. So let's start with point N and go 2 right and 6 down. Right there. So that was N. I'm going to label that N prime. Do that with all of the points. So K, you go 1, 2, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's going to be K prime. And L, if I'm at L, I go 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's going to be L prime. And M, if I go 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, M prime. So let's fill in the shape. And your result should be the exact same shape. It's just the whole thing has been slid right 2 and 6 down. 16. What are we doing? 4 right and 3 up. So each of these points, we're going to go here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, right there. That's F prime. And here's G. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. That would be G prime. E, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, E prime, draw the shape. So the whole shape has been moved 4 to the right, 3 up. Next one, 17 says a reflection. So this is different. A reflection across the y-axis, okay, so here's your y-axis. So what that means is you take point Q, and since that's 1 away from the y-axis, then put Q prime 1 away on the other side. Actually, I'm going to put that here because I know what's going to happen. R, look at R, point R. So 1, 2, 3, 4 away from the y-axis, so 1, 2, 3, 4 on the other side is where R prime would go. And S is 1, 2, 3, 4 away. So 1, 2, 3, 4 away is S prime. Draw your shape. Now that shape has been reflected across the y-axis. Now reflect across the x-axis. So do the same thing, but this time over the x-axis. So J prime would be right here. And I prime, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And H, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, right there. All right, now we're gonna put everything together, okay? We want to graph an equation. So when you look at number 19, you should notice that there's gonna be an x squared. Whatever else the numbers do, at some point there's gonna be an x squared, and you should know really quickly that this is gonna be a parabola shape. Okay, that's what the whole families of function thing is about. We know this is a parabola shape, and we can also see that it would be a parabola that's shifted to the left. One and down three. Okay, so whatever the parabola looks like, we're going to go left one and down three. So let's talk about a parabola shape for a second. A parabola shape has a special pattern. Okay, make sure you get this because this is a huge shortcut. All right, and I call that pattern the 1-3-5 pattern. If you can find the vertex, right, this is the vertex, the lowest point of a parabola, or the highest, I guess, if it's flipped. But all you have to do is, for the next point, you go over one and up one, and then you go over one and up three, and you go over one and up five, and you're going to have a pretty nice-looking parabola if you follow that 1-3-5 pattern. Okay, so think about our transformations here. We're supposed to go left one and down three. So let's do that. If I'm at the origin, I watch your scale. This is a weird scale because it doesn't go by, you know, a tick mark is not one. A tick mark is 0.5. So be careful there. If you go left one, that actually puts you to right there. And down one, two, three. Again, watch your tick marks, watch your scale. But that's where the vertex would be. If you go left one and down three, that's the vertex of your parabola. That's this point. Okay? Now, here's your shortcut. In order to get to the next point, I'm going to go, let's change color so you can see it better. Up one and over one. Notice that I'm looking at the numbers, not tick marks. And up one and over one the other way. Okay? Now, from that green point, let's do it again. But this time it's three. I'm going to go up one, two, three, and over one. And up one, two, three, and over one from that green point. Now, I can't go up five because I don't have enough room. But that's okay. I've got a pretty good-looking basic shape of my parabola right there. So parabola shape, I used my 1-3-5 pattern. Learn that. Number 20, here's another parabola shape. So we're going to have another 1-3-5. You look at your shifting, and this says left 4 and up 1. So if you start at the origin right here, and you're going to go left 1, 2, 3, 4, and up 1, that's where the vertex would be. So follow your 1-3-5. From that vertex, I'm going to go up one and over one in either direction, really. And from that point, I'm going to go up one, two, three, and over one. And two, three, and over one. And if I had room to keep going, I'd go up five and over one. But I don't have enough room, and that's fine. Let's just stop right there. It's a pretty good looking parabola for us. You've got your square root, so we know that's that eyebrow shape. Now, an eyebrow, interestingly, also has a 1-3-5 pattern, except this time it goes sideways instead of up. Your 1-3-5 goes to the right. So you look at your shifting, you look at your transformations, and this says left 2, and this says down 5. So if I'm at the origin, start at the origin, and watch your tick marks. Looks like I go left, one, two, and down, one, two, three, four, five, right there. That's where the starting point of my eyebrow would be. Okay? Now, in order to use the 1-3-5 pattern this time, we're going to go right, one, and up one. And then right, one, two, three, and up one. And then right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then up one. And you could keep going if you had more room, 7, 9, and so on and so on. That's my shape. Do your best to draw a smooth curve through there. And don't extend it past here. There's nothing to the left of that dot, so don't draw anything over there. It stops right there at that point, or it starts right there at that point. It does not go through that point. So we've got like that eyebrow shape. 22 is also an eyebrow shape. You need to shift it right one and up four. So start at the origin to go right one and up 1, 2, 3, 4. There's my starting point. There's this point of my eyebrow. So use your 1, 3, 5 going sideways. Go over one and up one. Over 1, 2, 3 and up one. And if I had room, I'd go over 5 and up one, over 7 and up one, and so on and so on. Since I'm out of room, that's about it, all I can do. That's terrible.